I want to check in with my friend Congressman Tom MacArthur, who is back from a diplomatic visit to Korea and wanted to check in with us and give us an update. Congressman, good morning. Welcome back.
Good morning, Bill. Thanks for having me.
You bet. So tell me what happened on your trip to Korea. What and how does this impact us here? And what do you think is going to happen now that people are kind of now we're no longer distracted by the election? We're like, oh, wait a minute. The world is very dangerous and there are things out there that need solving.
Well, there sure are, and that's an interesting and dangerous region in the world.
Yeah.
It was an odd trip as a member of Congress, Bill, because most of the time when we travel abroad, we do it in a group, you know, mm-hmm. 5 or 6 members of Congress. This was an invitation to me from the Korean government to come over there with an aide by myself, and it came out of a dinner that I was at with President Moon right after he was elected as the president of Korea. About a week and a half later, an invitation came through diplomatic circles, and I accepted under a program that the State Department controls that allows this sort of a visit. So I went, and I was there for the whole week. Normally, these delegations bounce from country to country. I was in that one place for a week. Had meetings with foreign minister, trade minister, national security people. I met with our military people there. I met with our commanding general on the peninsula, who not only commands the U.S. troops, but all of the UN and the combined forces with the South Koreans. So mm-hmm. it was really a very deep dive into that part of the country. And then I came back and had a visit at the White House to sort of debrief the things that I was able to see and experience there. And then, of course, the president is there right now. And so I'll tell you what struck me the most.
Yeah.
A couple of things. First of all, they are deeply intertwined with our country. We literally saved South Korea in the early 1950s. The communists had taken over the entire peninsula. And it's the Americans that drove them out. And I went to the war memorial. Mm-hmm. You can just see from those who died, Bill, people who died from the state of New Jersey yeah. outnumber most other countries.
Really? No kidding.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yes. You literally have to go through 95% of the wall of all of those who died
wow.
before you get to another country. And so this.
My
this
father-in-law
America.
Served in Korea, and it's, you know, we've heard the stories, and it's like you're right about how intertwined it is with us, our military, and our mission of freedom around the world.
Yeah, we literally saved that part of the world from communism. For me, it's very meaningful because 2 of my 3 children we've adopted, and both of them were born in South Korea.
No kidding. How about that?
And so.
That's close to home for you.
Yeah, it was very close to home. And. You know, I went to the DMZ. You can't explain it unless you've been there how tense it is. Even my arrival, the North Koreans haven't answered the phone in 4 years that connects the north and the south side of the DMZ. 4 years they haven't picked up the phone,
mm-hmm.
and so they have to go to the border with a bullhorn and announce, "We're going to be bringing someone into the security building. Please don't shoot."
Wow.
These are 3 buildings that actually straddle the DMZ. And they brought me into the building, and we talked. We had a briefing. You could see the North Korean soldiers. In fact, if you go to my website, you can see a few soldiers peering in through the windows. But that's the relationship. And there's a lot of gamesmanship, but it's not a game, Bill. Hundreds of people have died during the armistice at the border.
How wide is it? How wide is that area?
Well, the entire DMZ is about the length of New Jersey. It's about 160 miles long, and the area where most of the interaction is the conflict, it's the security zone, and it's, you know, I don't know, maybe a quarter mile wide. It's a military encampment. And the North Koreans are on one side of it. And, you know, when I first got to the actual DMZ, 3 soldiers ran out of the North Korean security building, you know, with cameras and binoculars wow. to see who was coming, because I was there with the base, the UN secretary for the armistice. And so they ran out to see who's there, but you're literally right there on top of each other. And then these three negotiation buildings that actually straddle the DMZ, you know, they're under the control of both sides, but one side or the other will lock one of the buildings sometimes and sort of temporarily take control.
So what do you think? What do you think happens now? And I've only got about a minute left. What do you think happens now in terms of the administration policy? And my guess is the reality of the diplomatic negotiations are very different than what is reported in the media, where there's a lot of scare tactics, et cetera, typically used just to beat up on the president.
Well, I met yesterday with the person in Washington who represents the all of the trade interests in South Korea. I met with him and the person from the South Korean Trade Organization. They told me that the feedback they're getting is the president was spot on in his remarks. Mm-hmm. One, he was very strong about the fact that North Korea could not be allowed to get a nuclear weapon with ballistic missiles that could fire it anywhere on our allies or us. But two, he gave a path forward for the North Koreans. He talked about them coming back into contact with other nations. He wasn't just threatening their annihilation. He was giving them a path forward.
Right. Will they take it?
Well, the question is, will they take it? And I did learn one thing, though. I'm just as committed as I ever have been that they cannot be allowed to get both nuclear weapons and missiles. But I do believe, unless you're getting the day-to-day intelligence that the president gets, it's not only difficult, it's impossible to say what he ought to be doing every day about
So it. I'm going to get to your website. We're going to post some of those pictures, and I'm going to have this conversation put on NJ1015.com. And Congressman, let's stay in touch on this as things develop. But I appreciate your firsthand involvement and keeping us informed. And let's make sure we loop back around next week.
Okay, Bill. You take care.
All right, you bet. Thank you. All right, it was Congressman Tom MacArthur, fighting for all of us and doing a great job.